Aloha and welcome. Is it the 14th already? 14th of October, 2023. And here we are, another Saturday for another Saturday Sound Journey. And Kaimi and I are gonna play these instruments and hopefully lead you on a magical journey of evolutionary magnificence. And if not, at least you'll get some good sound. As always, the invitation is to find a comfortable place to sit or lay down. I prefer laying down, but I usually go to sleep if I do, and that's okay, because this music works on you regardless of your state of consciousness. Probably not regardless of your state of consciousness. I'm sure there's many states of consciousness that would benefit in different ways, but regardless of whether or not you're awake. It will get loud and soft and loud and soft and vary a lot, and then it'll get quite silent for about a minute. When it does, hang tight. I'm going to play the rap drum at the end for a few moments, and then I'm going to let it sit quiet for a few minutes more, and then I will talk you back. Invite you back into your body and breath. When it does get quiet, the invitation is for you to body scan, see where you are, how you're doing. You may want to scan as we get started, especially looking for any areas of blockage or tightness. Sound journeys are quite efficacious on removing energetic blocks. I make up if you're aware of them, and if you're not, you may become aware of them when the sound heats up. Sometimes that manifests as additional tension or a little bit of quivering. It's all okay. It's just your body doing what your body does. When I find areas like that, I like to breathe through and envision the blockages getting cleared out so that my meridians flow. I think that's one of the most noticeable effects of sound journeys. It also does a whole lot to calm your body and sink your brain, and get just relaxed. If you're in this room and you need to leave, if it gets to be too much for the loudness, just step out back. There's a couch and a chair out there. You're more than welcome to hang out there until the end. Or if it's way too much, you can leave. But if you do, make sure you drink water before you drive. Get grounded really well. My queen reminds me, even in my brain, without ever looking at her, that we're invited to bring an intention. The sound waves move through your interstitial tissue. That's all the tissue that holds your cells together on the inside, and the cells to the cells, and the muscles to everything. When that interstitial tissue gets movement with the sound waves, it generates energy, and that energy becomes available for you to use to manifest or support an intention. So always invited to think about what you want to have happen in your life, and you can use the energy for that. Or you can just enjoy the journey and sleep or whatever. We good? Kaimi and I like to breathe three times, three deep breaths, not uncomfortably deep, no strain or stress. And while we do those slow, full inhales and exhales, we ground into Mama Gaia. It sets up energy channels for any energy that gets let loose and unblocked that we're no longer needing. She can go right into Mama Gaia. She transmutes it and uses it for whatever she needs. And it also has the benefit of allowing channels for her gifts to come up into my root system and therefore up into me. That's the story I make up, and I'm sticking to it. All right? Grounding, journeying. We'll see y'all in an hour.
Thank you.
ish. Hello. That's really nice with the dress.
Thank you.
Mm. Should make more of those. As this sound journey draws to a close, and the last of these sound waves dances off into the universe, the invitation is to find your breath. To change it, just notice where it is. And allow that rhythmic inhalation and exhalation gently reel you back into your body. And as that awareness seeps back into this meat sack, you may notice that there is a desire to move. Perhaps your toes are desiring to dance a little. Maybe your hands are just itching to spread out, fingers wide. A little wiggle here and there. I invite you to allow that to happen. Because as the Borg say, resistance is futile. I was reminded today that as this perception of time seems to speed up, it's really important to allow for time of silence and stillness. Well, we got the stillness down tonight. Maybe not so much the silence. It's always important, I think, well, it's always important to stay hydrated, but I make up that after a sound journey when maybe things that have been sitting dormant for a while get shaken up, maybe become reacquainted with your circulatory system. But adding in a little extra water to allow things to flush is a really groovy idea. Makes my brain work better too. For those in the digital world, mahalo nui loa for joining us on this Eclipse Saturday. If it's not actually October 14th, 2023, where you are, welcome. This is a morphogenic field, and I believe that your energy was here right now. Fortunately, there's not much consequence if I'm wrong. Good idea to protect, shield, to pay attention to your emotional environment too. I find that Gong journeys kind of open me up a little bit, and I like to surround myself with good people who like to hug for a few days to help keep that equilibrium. Librium? Did someone say librium? Thank you. Aloha. We'll see you next time. If you're on YouTube, smash that like button.
Mahalo.
拜拜。